And also, I'd like to
Yeah.
quickly point out that when I read that report that was put out by the task force for the CFR, one thing that they're saying that Canada and Mexico are the biggest suppliers of oil to the United States at this time. And also, the something like 80% of the natural gas that's going down the United States comes from Canada. So what, like I've said in the past, Canada is nothing more than Liefen space. It's basically it's living space is what the terms that the Nazis used back in World War II to justify taking over Poland and also heading towards the breadbasket of the Ukraine to basically support themselves in the end. But what happened was is you know. What we have to do, we the people, we have to start reading this information. And, you know, for the people out there that don't want to read, there are programs out there, electronic reader programs, that you can go copy everything, put it in this electronic reader, and sit there and do something totally different and just put headphones on and read it. Because we have to start getting this information. We have to realize what their next step is going to be. And their next step is they're being blatant right now because they're telling us what they're going to do.
Yeah.
And when we, the people, we're sitting there going, no, there's no way they're going to do that. And you're saying, and you know, like I'll be sitting there looking at it going, yeah, they will. Will do that, but you know, a lot of people will sit there going, no, they won't. And you know, it's kind of scary, but at the same time, is if we the people join together, you know, with all your music that you're doing and Kevin, your writing that you're doing, you know, if we can basically use these two outlets and the radio at the same time to start uniting the people together as one common cause to stand up against these New World Order elitist, you know, then we the people we can win. I mean, that's basically my thought. That we can stop them. They can be stopped because they're only human beings.
Yeah, and we got to prepare now for, you know, if and when, for example, our programs are taken off the air, we've got to have backups, you know, through the internet and that to carry on this radio program and other things. And I agree that we're the majority. And in fact, you know, I see that every time we hold protests, you know, I make a point of going over and talking to the police, and they are very uninformed about a lot of this stuff. And once you educate them about, you know, the role of their government and their churches in genocide, they start waking up too. So I think the power of ideas is what we have to rely on. That's where our strength lies.
Yeah, we all just need to inform ourselves and open our minds, and like you were saying, Reggie, is like, yeah, if you don't feel like reading, you can put on headphones now and you can have a book being read to you and you can get the information. So there's many different ways to become informed and to be prepared for what's happening, because I really feel the changes that are going to be happening, most people are going to want them. They're going to embrace them, and that's what the scary aspect of it is that we're something's going to happen, that we're going to be set up, that majority of the people are going to embrace the New World Order, the North American Union, the Amero. Like, this recession could still become a depression.
Yeah, one of the things when I was reading that report that's put out by the task force there, one of the ways that they're justifying this, they're justifying it, they're going after the illegal drugs. We only have a couple minutes left, so I'm going to quickly finish this point and then I'll hand over to Kevin yourself for final words. But they're justifying this by saying, oh, we're going after the illegal drugs, when the CIA were the ones that started running all these drugs into United States. So one hand they're collecting the money, and the next hand they're going, oh no, we want to stop other people from doing this, and oh, at the same time, you know, this didn't happen, we're going to create a new future sort of thing. But with that said, Gemini, we have about 2 minutes left. Could you quickly leave some last minute words to the listening audience, and also when's the next concert that you're going to have?
Okay, well, our next show, Conspirituality, will be performing on July 13th in Gastown at the Modern. You can check us out on conspirituality.com. We're on MySpace. You can hear the music. We just released a double CD, so that's available on iTunes, on CD Baby. Conspirituality, Conspirituality. Google us. Find out all that information. Get up to date on our shows. We're going to be touring here pretty soon. We'll be on the island, so jump on our Facebook. I don't like promoting all these computer pages, but it's the best way for us to be in touch with our fan base right now. So we have to find new ways. So look us up and come and see us.
Yeah, we have to find new ways because by 2010, the Telus and Bell are talking about you know, start making it pay more for the internet, having packages like they have for cable. But Kevin, we have about 30 seconds left. You want some last words you want to leave for the listening audience?
Just stay tuned because our program Hidden from History is next.
Well, thank you very much. Well, I'd like to thank Kevin and Nat for coming in here, and I'd like to thank Gemini for calling in here right now. And this is Co-op Radio 102.7 FM CFRO, Monday Brown Bagger. The date is July 6th. My name is Reginald Angus Argue. We're going to take a brief break, and then Kevin will be coming back with his show. Thank you so much, Sir Gemini.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.